Happy Sabbath, Church. November is my favorite month of the year, and Thanksgiving is my favorite holiday. My wife, Mia, and son, Thomas, cook up an amazing and delicious meal each year, which we share with friends and family. Shelly and I simply serve as sous chefs and the cleanup crew. There are two other reasons for me to love November. My birthday is November 18th, and November is when the football season really heats up and teams begin their run for the playoffs. November is typically a trifecta of fun for me. Of course, this November has been like no other in my lifetime. We are hosting Thanksgiving today as I tape this message, but with only a few family members and friends. My birthday celebration was done remotely, except for immediate family, and my Baltimore Ravens are having an uncharacteristically poor November. But enough of the rouser pity party. Of course, we all understand the impact that COVID-19 has had on our lives, family, friends, and for us healthcare workers, our patients. How can we give thanks when so much disruption has occurred in our lives, the loneliness, the loss of freedoms, even the loss of life? A friend and colleague of mine, Dr. Jeffrey Ng, is fond of quoting this scripture text, Psalms 34:1. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. All times, continually, in good times and bad. Why? Because of the gift of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who blesses us with his love and grace and has his kingdom waiting for his people. This is what we should be most thankful for. Happy Thanksgiving and have a happy holiday season.
for my mom, dad, Ethan, Aaron, Alex, and my dog, Chloe. I'm thankful for my grandparents.
I'm thankful for my cousins and friends.
I'm thankful for Auntie Grace for teaching us Sabbath school every week.
I'm thankful for my notebooks.
I'm thankful for my mom. I'm thankful for my dad. I'm thankful for Squeaky. I'm thankful for Bootsy. I'm thankful for Tommy. I'm thankful for Bodie. I'm thankful for Appa. I'm thankful for myself. And
I'm thankful for... Dugo.
Attention. Hi, B. Hi, me. Attention. Hi, Ma. Oma. Appa. So,
I am thankful for my friends and family and my house.
I am thankful for my family.
I believe in God our Father. I believe. Today's scripture is found in 1 Thessalonians 5:16 through 18. It reads, "Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Jesus Christ."
All right, let's bow our heads for prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I just want to thank you for the Sabbath and also for the season of Thanksgiving, where we can still come together with family and close friends and just really spend the time to be thankful for each other and what we have. Please be with Pastor Richard as he gives us the word. I just pray that you speak through him and that you open our hearts to be able to accept what he has for us today. I pray all these things in your name. Amen.
When the leaves turn red and the mountains look like a masterpiece painting, when the temperature drops and we bring out our jackets and sweaters in November, you know what all of us are thinking, right? It's Thanksgiving. While in Southern California, leaves do not color, mountains are always ugly, temperature drops to only about 70 degrees, and we wear long sleeves and shorts together in November. But still, we know it's Thanksgiving. I hope you had a great Thanksgiving day with your family. But I have a question. When the fall comes and Thanksgiving time nears, what do you think about? When you hear the word Thanksgiving, what comes to your mind? You know what most people think of? Turkey and shopping, the food and the deals. We do not think about giving thanks. We think about veggie turkey, Black Friday, and Cyber Monday. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you're with us all the time. And this Thanksgiving Day kind of reminds us of your presence and of your blessings, Father. But help us to learn more about what true thanksgiving, or what truly giving thanks to God, means today. Now, as we open the Bible, open our hearts also. In Jesus' name, amen. Before we look at today's passage, we have a big announcement. We have a new youth pastor. His name is Pastor Kane Kim, and he'll be starting next week on December 1st. Okay, he's our new youth pastor. We have a very special event planned to celebrate him and his starting at our church on December 12th Sabbath afternoon from 3:30 to 5 o'clock. It's RSVP only, and it's for youth and youth families only. So please mark your calendars and be prepared to welcome Pastor Kane Kim. We are super excited to have him. Now, let's look at today's main passage. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, 16 through 18. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 5. Chapter 5, verses 16 through 18. Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Aren't these verses just great? I love today's passage. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Have you ever wondered what God's will is for you? This is a bold statement here at the end of passage saying, this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Have you? Have you wondered what God's will for your life is? You know, this is an important question. Have you ever gone on an airplane but you don't know what the destination was. I know nobody does that, right? I mean, it's kind of funny if you think about it. Like, you go on a plane and then you don't know where you're headed. Like, you have no idea what the destination is. Do you ever do that? No, right? If you have a plane ticket, you know where you're going. If you if you're gonna buy a ticket and go on a plane, you have a destination in mind. You wouldn't live your life like that, right? I mean, unbelievers could do that. I'll just go wherever life takes me. But not us. We know who made us, and we know He made us with a purpose. So we want to know what the will of our Maker is for my life. Many times in my life, I wished I really knew what God's will for me was. And today's passage tells us. Oh, you want to know what God's will is for you? Here it is. Rejoice always, pray unceasingly, and give thanks in all circumstances. We often think that God's will for us will be something grandioso, right? We think that God probably wants me to sell everything and just like move to Africa, like something incredibly hard. And on an individual level, God does direct you to certain places or specific people or particular paths. They have a special calling. For most of us, we've been led to live in Loma Linda, like you and me. Some have become pastors or teachers or healthcare professionals or other vocations. But in general, on the universal level, God wants us to rejoice, pray, and give thanks. This is God's will for everyone. The phrase God's will here can also be translated to God's desire for you or what pleases God. Today's passage tells us what pleases God. What pleases God is for us to rejoice, pray, and give thanks. If you ever wondered what God wants from you or what His will is for you, here it is. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, and give thanks in all circumstances. In Greek, these are all written in imperative. Like, God commands you, okay? This is what God really wants you to do, okay? God wants you to find joy in Christ in all the time. Not just when you get a raise or when your kids do well in school or when good things happen to you, but all the time. You already have the reason to be happy, right? Right? And celebrate. Why? Because you have Jesus. You know the gospel, the good news. God wants us to pray without ceasing. It means to depend on Him continually, not just for the big things, but also the little things too. Not just for critical things or desperate things in life, not just when you hit a wall in life, but in all things, we need to build dependence upon Him. Don't come to God only when you get in trouble, but be in continual conversation with God. So that's the idea. Now, this is the key verse for today, okay? Give thanks in all circumstances, the third one. There are situations where it's easy to give thanks. In good times, nobody needs to be reminded to give thanks, right? Normally, think about this. When do we give thanks? I'll tell you when we give thanks. You're driving and you almost hit something or someone almost hits you, right? And you go, oh, thank God. You thank God because Nothing bad happened. Thank God, everything is okay. We give thanks when the situation improves too. I was sick, but now I feel better, thank God. I was out of job, but now I got hired, thank God. I was really struggling in this class, but I passed the first year, thank God. Today's passage says, thank God and give God glory and give thanks to Him in all circumstances, in everything. Thank God in good and in bad. Give thanks when you have reason and when you also feel like you have no reason at all. Scripture tells us today, give thanks in all circumstances. In good times, it's easy to give thanks to God, but how do we give thanks to God in bad times? So that's the question, right? How do we give thanks in hurt, in difficulty, in pain? We need our gratitude to shape our circumstances instead of the circumstances shape our gratitude. Our gratitude is not dependent on the situation or the circumstances. How's year 2020 going for you? Has anyone been having the best year of life? Anyone? When I think about the children in pandemic, I just feel terrible for them. They can't play like they used to. No hugging, no touching. They can't even freely run around and play with their friends. Teenagers have it the worst. We all know online school sucks, right? You have to do school online, homework online, church online, and even your social life online. You're online all day long. It's ridiculous. For young adults and adults, we don't know what to do. We don't even know where to go. Everything's closed. Vacation is canceled. Everything's closed. Did I mention that? Life in 2020 for the elderlies is simply depressing. It's so lonely. It's risky to see family. It's actually dangerous to see your own grandchildren. Every time they get out of the house, it's unsafe. The lockdown, the economy, the political unrest, job insecurity, the circumstances of this year, have been nothing but trouble for all of us. We look at our situation. There's nothing to be grateful for, right? We're just all tired of everything these days. If we give thanks to God only in good times, this year is definitely going to be a pass, right? 2020 is canceled. Loma Linda Church, you know me. I'm usually a very happy person. But as I look at my life, it's like my church has been taken away from me. I can't be with my faith community, my spiritual family. Not gonna lie, it's been tough. It's been hard. For me, this year probably has been the most challenging time of my life. Can we just complain today? LLKC, this is why I love today's passage so much. Verse 18 says, in all circumstances, even in pandemic, it's saying, be grateful in all situations, give thanks to God in all circumstances. When life is good and when life is hard, in brokenness, in pain, in hurt, we can give God thanks. You know what we usually do? We rejoice when things are great, right? We got reason to be happy and celebrate. And when the trials come, like that's when we pray, right? Like, oh, you know, I'm in trouble. God, help me. Please get me through this. And when the situation improves, that's when we give thanks to God. Today's passage says, always, continually, in all circumstances. Remember those three words. So, ever since I came to Loma Linda Church, there is one day of the year that's like I'm the busiest. You know what day it is? It's the graduation day. So busy. I mean, some years, we had over 40 students graduating in one day. There's a math school in the morning, farm school at noon, dental school in the evening, and there's Allied Health has several programs graduating every 2 hours. There's a La Sierra, Loma Linda Academy, Redlands Academy. So busy. By the way, 2020 was the most relaxed graduation season ever. But I felt so sad for the graduates. We graduate from kindergarten. We graduate from elementary. Actually, that's a promotion. We graduate from junior high and high school to college, college to grad school. You learn and you go to the next level. It's called graduation. We start in our grade school, right? But we graduate. We mature and mature and end up in professional school. You don't want to stay in kindergarten for the rest of your life. If you think about it, it's the same way in our spiritual walk. We can't have kindergarten faith forever. You need to mature. You don't want to be that Christian who rejoices only when good things happen. You don't want to be that believer who prays only when things go wrong. You don't want to be that person who gives thanks to God only when the situation improves. You may ask, why? Why should we be thankful in trials? When I'm hurting, why should I give thanks? LLKC, you know this. In trials, we're building the qualities that God wants to see. In trials, we grow and mature. In trials, we are formed to be precious stones. In times of difficulties, God is producing in us the qualities that He wants to develop in us that give glory and honor to God. When we face hard situations, when the situation is bad, it's crunch time. Let God build us. Many years ago, I've introduced to our church the Japanese art of kintsugi, right? Kintsugi. The Japanese art of kintsugi can help you deal with stressful situations. Kintsugi is a Japanese art of putting broken pottery pieces back together with gold. It embraces flaws, imperfections, brokenness, trials, and you can create an even stronger, more beautiful piece of art. The cracks or the scars are part of the design and bring unique beauty to the art. In life, sometimes in the process of repairing or healing that which have been broken and shattered, something more unique, beautiful, and resilient is actually created. As the whole world looks broken and shattered, in these dark times, we can end up as broken jars to be thrown out, or we can become a beautiful piece of art. LLKC, we are going to be a beautiful art, right? That's the kind of community that we want to become, right? Let's be grateful for this experience. Let's give thanks to God for forming us into a kintsugi community. I pray that 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 16 through 18, become our church. Let's become a happy church all the time. Together, let's build an atmosphere of joy, which makes its the members feel that we're bathed in sunshine. Life in Jesus should be exhilarating and not depressing. Our church should overflow with joy of heaven all the time. LAKC, let's be a praying community. I ask all of you to spend time on your knees with your hands up in the air in prayer. May the prayer be the heartbeat of our church. Loma Linda Church, we must become a church with gratitude. There's always something for which to give thanks. Even on the darkest day, there are blessings to count. We must remember that even on a cloudy day, the sun shines above the clouds, waiting for the moment to give warmth and light. Remember that. I heard from someone that if you count your blessings, it can help with depression. I heard this from a physician. I did. If you count five things you are grateful for, it can help you heal. We need our gratitude to shape our circumstances instead of the circumstances shaping our gratitude. Then we can start walking in God's will for us. My wife, Amy, and her grandmother were very close. Her grandma was very fun-loving person. She was so friendly and super active. They used to do a lot of things together. She was misdiagnosed with some type of cancer, and she was on her. She seemed to be on her deathbed. On one Thanksgiving day, Amy went over to visit her grandma and take her some food. She was so sick, coughing up blood and having difficulty breathing. They had to remove one of her lungs in the following year. Amy was just really sad and emotional because her grandma couldn't be with the family on her favorite holiday, Thanksgiving Day. Amy shared these regrets with the grandma. But to Amy's surprise, grandma comforted Amy with a smile and she said, "It's okay, Amy, don't worry about me. It's not forever. It's not forever. Whatever circumstances you may be in right now, it's not forever." Right? No one in the church, think about that. This world we live in, this broken world, the world that we live in, this pandemic that we live in, it's not forever. Even if grandma had died in that moment, it wouldn't have been forever, because we have that kind of hope in Christ Jesus. That's reason to rejoice always. That's reason to pray all the time without ceasing. Reason to give thanks in all circumstances. For years here in Loma Linda, I've been preaching. When the trials hit us, we can either turn sour or turn sweet. When the hardships come, we can either come out bitter or come out better. Now, LAKC, it's time for me to practice what I preached. Now, it's time for you to practice what you have learned. So here it is, Loma Linda Church. Rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. Give thanks in all circumstances. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for all that you do in our lives. We're thankful for all the blessings. But Lord, help us to realize that regardless of the good things, regardless of the blessings that we receive, help us to always rejoice, pray continually, and give thanks in all circumstances. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace.